And it goes a little something like, if you struggle making smooth lines in Procreate, then you will love this new feature that Procreate 5.2 will have. If you go to the Brush Studio, then you will find this new tab, Stabilization. And it has a whole bunch of options. You can play around with the motion filtering, stabilization, and streamline to make all your lines super smooth. Even if you have super wonky line power, Procreate will undo that. And making line art will be very easy. Say goodbye to wonky lines.
Today we're learning about how to use Alpha Lock in Procreate. Create a shape in a new layer, and then fill the shape with a solid color. Head to the Layers panel and click Alpha Lock, select a new color, and then you can only draw inside the original shape. Next time we're talking clipping masks.
Procreate Hacks for Beginners Speed Theory. Draw a line and hold pencil down and it will straighten. Touch other finger and it will snap to 45 degree angles. Draw a circle and hold. Click Edit Shape and Circle to create perfect circle. Two finger tap to undo, three finger tap to redo. Drag color to fill in closed areas. Tap and hold with finger to select a color. Tap and hold color to revert back to previous color.
Here's a little tip I wish I would have known when I started digital art.
I make concept art for Epic, and here are a few things I made with this tip. After you finish your sketch in Procreate, select the silhouette of your character with the lasso tool. Next, fill drop the goober with color. Add in a layer and with three fingers set to clipping mask. Repeat this action with a new layer. Now your lines and color will stay within the shape you originally created. Continue using this method to get amazing results. Let me know if this helped. Follow and let me know what you want me to explain next.
To make an animation in Procreate, go to the wrench, then to canvas and turn on animation assist. Then start drawing on your layer. Or follow the You Can Draw This tutorial of this cute little flame. Every layer or layer group becomes a frame in your animation. Continue making new frames by making new layers or new layer groups. Once you have made enough frames, click play here at the bottom and watch your cheerful animation. Made a mark on your painting and you can't figure out on what layer it is? Here's an easy fix. Go to the wrench, then to prefs, and then to gesture controls. Then go to layer select and pick any of the options, like touch for example. Turn it on, then click done. And now you can touch your painting anywhere with your finger and see on what layer the thing you're touching is, like this mark. It's a layer 4 and it's automatically selected. So now we can grab the eraser and erase.
I've just figured out how to get rid of pixelation when resizing on Procreate. So for ages, whenever I would resize, I'd get a horrible pixelation on the lines like this. But if you select the Move tool and change the interpolation to
If you use Procreate, I'm not too sure if you know, but you can actually have a guide around where your brush is. And some of you may be using it like this, but that's okay. Let's get it so you can see the guide. Go to Actions, go to Preferences. You're going to toggle on the brush cursor so now you can see the edges of your brush whenever you're drawing.
This is how to blend colors. First off, you need to actually just draw your colors on there. You can do this in any way. I usually go from the corners and like going from dark to light, but you can honestly do whatever you want. I am currently using the hard airbrush on a very big setting. But this part, you can get creative and you can do a lot of different things. So once you've finished all of your colors, you're gonna click the magic wand, click Gaussian Blur, and click Layer. Now touch your pencil and slide it to the right until it is blended to where you want it. Now that you have the color, you can add another layer, put it underneath, make the colored layer a clipping mask, and anything you draw on this bottom layer, the colors are gonna show through. Comment any more Procreate questions you have.
What I wish I knew when I first got Procreate Part 5. The first one is I wish I knew you could take different pieces of art to different layers. Such a handy dandy tool. The second one is, I wish I knew you could move multiple pieces of art with the cursor tool at the same time. Just do that by swiping right on whatever layers you want to move. The next one is, I wish I knew we could do this super fun rotational symmetry. You do this by turning the drawing guide on and then going edit drawing guide, turning on symmetry, and then in options doing radial and rotational. Then you can just draw and it will repeat itself. It's super fun. All the same rules apply here. You can also use the selection tool to color just in a certain part if that was what you were going for. Thanks for following along in the series.
A lot of people have asked me this, and it's how to draw people in perspective. I'm going to show you two things. First, how do you get your person in perspective? What I'm about to show you will work for animals, cars, just about anything. First, you determine the height of your character and draw a box. Second, you could take a quick sketch and distort it to fit your box. Lastly, you draw your clean sketch over your guide, and now you have a person in perspective. Now, what if I want to add a character of similar height over here? You can draw a guide from the top of the character's head and the bottom of the character's feet to this new location. Now you know the new height of the character placed back here. And you can do this many times in your scene. I hope this helps. Let me know if you have any other questions, and don't forget to follow for more.
I just found out there's a halftone filter in Procreate. I've been using a halftone brush this entire time.
I'm going to show you guys one of my favorite Procreate tips. First, I made a new canvas that was 4,000 by 4,000 pixels, clicked on the wrench, canvas, drawing guide on, edit drawing guide. Click on symmetry, and then it automatically splits it in half, so if you want to switch that, go to options, and I chose quadrant. Now choose your favorite brush. I like monoline, and then anything you draw in one quadrant will be mirrored in the other three quadrants. So I decided to sketch these koi fish, and it's just really an amazing way to make a pattern that's super interesting and detailed, because you only have to draw everything once and then it's perfectly reflected in the other three quadrants. So you can definitely come up with a lot of different things, and this is what I came up with. Then I saved it as a PNG file with a transparent background and got it printed on these bandanas. So hope this helps.
I've been using Procreate for a while, and this is a tip I just learned. So whenever your shape doesn't fill the way you want it to, all you have to do is adjust the color threshold. And you do this by holding and sliding, and you can see the little bar at the top. And make sure you don't have any lines, and it filled.